Hey folks, Lawrence Triple here, president of the Florida Real Estate Investor Association, bringing you this week's edition of The Fan, and let's go over the headlines, what's going on. Obama administration pushing banks to modify mortgages. Palm Beach climbing back as a hotspot. Rents expected to climb by double digits. K. Schiller expects home values to drop 15 to 25% in 2011. Building permits take a plunge. And where's the $1 billion? All right, let's see what's going on here. In the Huffington Post, they are reporting here that the Obama administration is pushing banks to modify mortgages. That's right. The Obama administration is seeking to force the nation's five biggest lenders to reduce monthly payments for as many as 3 million distressed homeowners. Okay, now hopefully this doesn't turn out like the HAMP, but let's see what's going on. I'll tell you a little bit more. It's a big article here. They want to help these distressed homeowners in as little as 6 months as part of an agreement to settle accusations of improper foreclosures and violation of consumer protection laws. So this is a deal. They're trying to help the banks. Hey, you guys have broken the law. We're here to give you a deal. So let's see how it works out. Well, the modified mortgage could cost the financial behemoths. This is Bank of America, JP Morgan, Chase, Citigroup, Wells Fargo, and Ally Financial as much as $30 billion. All right, so that's quite a bit of a chunk change there they've got to fork out. Banks will have to modify both expensive and inexpensive mortgages. People involved in the talks are saying that. Banks would also likely have to forgive mortgage principal in situations where a predetermined formula dictated that it was the best way to modify a home loan. So these little numbers that they've created for themselves, that, hey, is it worth foreclosing or modifying? Well, now this will supersede that. Balances on second mortgages and home equity loans, of which nearly half of all outstanding loans are owned by Bank of America, JP Morgan, Citi, and Wells, would also have to be written down. But not all federal agencies are on board, and you still have the 50 states' attorneys generals that are also in this mess. So even though the states' attorneys generals are working with the federal agencies, they all have to come into agreement on this thing. So this could... who knows how long this will take. The banks don't want to go it alone, though. They want to pull Fannie and Freddie into this whole mess. They want to say, hey, you coming in here? But that's not likely to happen. The regulators that handle Fannie and Freddie said, listen, you've already cost the taxpayers enough money. We're not going to be a part of this. You're on your own. The number of targeted modifications range from 1 to 3 million, and the time frame to restructure the loans ranges from 6 to 18 months. Stiff penalties would be assessed if banks failed to meet their quotas. The penalties would make noncompliance costlier than modifying the troubled mortgages themselves. So I guess they're going to make sure that hurts on this one. Well, we'll see if this goes through. If you guys know, HAMP is up to get voted out. It looks like Republicans are going to say we get rid of HAMP, and the Democratic side, the Democratic-controlled Senate might also agree to let it go as well. All right, on the Post, Palm Beach Post, Palm Beach climbing back is a hot spot. That's right. Barron's ranked, they rank every year the 15 best places for a second home, and Palm Beach came in at 9th place. Yeah, they're calling Palm Beach part of the Iron Triangle of America's high society, which means that people live in New York, winter in Palm Beach, and summer in the Hamptons. So we're looking like we're coming back. Yeah, there's an $87 million spec home that's up for sale. If that goes through... bam, that they're saying this would be the key to launch Palm Beach back onto its high horse that it once was. All right. CNNmoney.com, they're reporting here that rents are expected to climb by double digits. This is according to rent.com. Demand for rental housing is already starting to increase. Now, this is nationwide numbers. Vacancy rates have hit below 10% for the first time in many years. I think this is back to from 2006, so about 5 years. But now in the South, as including Florida, Georgia, and a couple other states, we have dropped, I think, to about 11%. So we've seen an improvement here in the South. They're saying that more than 1.2 million young adults had moved back with their parents from 2005 to 2010 are now going back. They're getting rid of roommates, and they're doing it on their own and renting their own places. Some markets are expecting rental rates to climb as much as anywhere from 10 to 30% in the next few years. So not bad there for landlords. All right. K. Schiller expects home values to drop 15 to 25% in 2011. All right. They're saying the loans are too hard to acquire for the average home buyer. There's a glut of properties. But you know, no, this was on the CNNmoney.com on their video. And one thing I didn't hear the commentator speak about was creative financing. That's the one thing these guys don't look into is, hey, what puts us all together, what makes us investors is the creative financing. We know how to put something together and we know how to move things. And so that's the one thing these guys did not discuss. They were talking about all this gloom and doom, but hey, they forgot about the creative financing, lease options, you know, helping seller back financing, all this stuff that we know how to do and put together to help people get into homes. So, you know, do I see a decrease? Yeah, there probably is, but not in the reasons that I believe Kay Schiller was explaining. Anyway, all right, another report here. Building permits plunge. Yeah, they took a big fall here in February. Yeah, the February numbers showed some lackluster numbers as building permits fell to an annual rate of 517,000. Now, I believe the economists were believing that we would be at about 535,000, so it dropped a little bit more than they expected. Yeah, this is down 8.2% from January. New home construction also dropped more than expected in February, falling at its fastest rate since March 1984. Single-family home construction fell 11.8% during the month of February, but a huge decline in apartment buildings was an even bigger drag on the overall number. And that's huge because apartment buildings are... These two are leading movers of business here, and so quite a bit drop there. Construction of buildings with five units or more, which tends to be volatile month to month, fell 47% in February after surging 80% in January. All right, so what does all this mean? Is this good or bad? Hey, I think it's not so bad news. Not great for the builders that want to make some, you know, money by building more properties. But what we're seeing is that now there's not so many more properties that are becoming online. So what do you say? It's like, okay, now we'll be able to get rid of some of the properties that are on the market and see those move again. And then, you won't see a whole bunch of new houses coming online. So good and bad news. Hey, it all depends on how you look at it. For the investor, not so bad news. All right, this is from tcpalm.com. Remember we had talked about the $1 billion that Florida had received, actually it was $1.05 billion, to help homeowners that are in distress? Well, we hadn't heard anything about it, so we did a little investigating and discovered here that it's tied up in Tallahassee. Yeah. The first batch of the money had hit. It's from called the Federal Hardest Hit Program. $418 million was awarded to the state more than a year ago. Now remember, we talked about that they did a trial period in Lee County and trying to help some people out there. And so now there's still a few million more dollars sitting there that aren't getting done. Well, what's happening? They're saying the delay is based partly on technical issues with the Hardest Hit website. You got $1 billion and you can't put it together a website? All right, who knows what is the real reason. The group is also educating the governor, Scott, about the program, so make sure that he's on board with it. So, and then there's no say as to when this money is going to be available. Out of the five first states, Florida was one of them, we're the only state that has not implemented the program. So there's families that have fallen behind that aren't going to meet the quota anymore because now they are too far behind. I think the limit is 5 or 6 months. Behind, or 180 days, that's right. It can't be more than 180 days, which is 6 months. After that, they don't qualify. Well, there's some families that are screaming that, hey, listen, when we first heard about the money, we were only a few months behind. Now that the delay is taking so long, now we're further behind, and now we don't qualify. So, yeah, leave it to red tape, right? All right, so, that's where the $1 billion is sitting, up in Tallahassee. All right, what's going on with the NFL? Yeah, I was going to talk a little bit about the Dolphins, but the NFL here, the Players Union, has notified all the owners that on Friday it had decertified and walked away from mediation and collective bargaining to initiate the antitrust litigation it has been threatening to file. So I guess they didn't like the deal that was on the table, and now they're walking away, and will we have a season this year? Well, who knows? We'll see, huh? Time will only tell. All right, that's the news this week, and let's see what's going on at the FLREIA. We have our virtual membership now available, so don't forget about that if you are outside of the South Florida area and want to participate in the FLREIA's meetings and workshops. Be sure to tune in here to find out how you can participate through the virtual membership. Don't forget, every Tuesday afternoon at 12:15 is our Real Estate Opportunities webinar. We've got folks from all over the world tuning into this thing, so be sure that you are a part of it. And then... We are still collecting bicycles through the Dreams on Wheels program. If you've got a bicycle that's for a five-year-old or up, male or female, new or used with some small modifications needed, give Christian a call, and you'll see the number right now here on the screen. It is 561-574-7733, and they'll schedule a pickup. So we have until the end of April to collect 50 bikes, which is the goal. All right, and congratulations to Mike Poole. He won our cash flow game tournament last Friday. He did it in under an hour, so good job there, Michael. Don't gloat, okay? Your head's too big already. Anyway, all right, what else is going on? We've got the Hidden Power of LLCs. That is going to be a webinar that we're going to be posting on FLREIA.com/LLC. That will be available March 21st through April 1st. There'll be a limited time that is available, so make sure you tune in there. And then our God's Property on Thursday morning on the 17th at 7:30 a.m. Be sure to register for that. Then our meeting, our grand event meeting every month is going to be on the 17th at PGA National Resort and Spa. And we're going to teach you how to unlock your IRA or unlock your friend's IRA or buddy's IRA. Find out how you can tap into the trillions of dollars that's available in IRA money to invest in real estate. Then on the 19th, you can discover how to negotiate like a pro. And you guys know Sharon is a pro at negotiating, and she's going to be teaching some of her secrets on Saturday on March 19th. So make sure you register for that. And then on the 26th, we have our partnership workshop. For those of you in the partnership program, make sure you register for that and join Sharon as she teaches you guys some more tricks of the trade. And then our Ocean Club has an unofficial meeting at the boat show. That's right. The boat show is here in Palm Beach on March 26th. We will be there in the afternoon. So we're going to post some more information as we get some more. So just stay tuned to our calendar of events to see what's going on there. And then our Elite Power Trip, we will be gone with the Elite members on the 31st through the 3rd. We'll be up in the Biltmore and doing one of the Land Rover test drives through some mud and some stuff. So it should be a lot of fun. We're looking forward to it. Get away, some getaway time. All right, don't forget to follow us on our social media pages on YouTube, Facebook. What else we got? Twitter. And don't forget to tune in on our blog. All right, that is the news. And don't forget, keep your prayers for those folks in Japan and that earthquake and tsunami. Still tragic, a lot of lives lost, but through prayer we can do a lot. So don't forget to do that. And if you can donate, check out your American Red Cross website and throw some money their way. All right, that's it for this week. Thanks for tuning in, and we look forward to seeing you at any one of our upcoming events. This is Juan with Shrepo signing off. God bless.